The buck stops at Vergelegen. For the past 5 years, the Ganto project focused on the eland's impact on Strandveld and will now focus on Renosterveld.
The Ganto project focuses on investigating eland as a veld management tool for Strandveld and Renosterveld. So we started with the Cape Flatoon Strandveld, that's an endangered vegetation type at the Rondo Planet Reserve, and now the next phase will be to look at Renosterveld. The five ambassador eland is Mike and Gibbs, and the females are Little P, Unico and Bernie.
The eland will browse vegetation and prevent bush encroachment. This will result in regenerating the diversity of the veld and allow the ecosystem to function more effectively.
And we've moved the animals now between a few different sites, and they're coming now to rest, I believe, at Vergelegen, to have a big impact on the veld here, and hopefully to carry on being ambassadors for our natural vegetation and for the efforts made in conservation around the city.
Vergelegen provided a fenced 10-hectare camp, far removed from its other operations. Estate management has also undertaken to monitor the animals' health.
And I think with this morning opening of that boma and releasing those eland onto this property was just an amazing and emotional experience more than anything else. It is as if those eland always belonged here and have always been here. It's like they've never been away.
The Cape Town Environmental Education Trust erected a boma for shelter. The impact of the eland on the veld will be monitored using drones and spectral imaging, as well as on-the-ground flora and fauna surveys. Tanya Krauser, SABC News, Western Cape.